Top story in the NFL, Jalen Ramsey to the Rams. Dante Fowler, his new teammate, tweeting, "Today's been one of the most emotional roller coasters I've been on in a while. Welcome to LA, brother." Of course, yeah. Marcus Peters shipped out earlier in the
day.
That
was his homie.
To Baltimore.
About as rare as it gets in the NFL when a player gets traded for two first-round draft picks. I'm going to throw out some names that have had that happen. Cool. You tell me if it was good trade or not. Right. Khalil Mack.
Great trade.
Yeah. Jay Cutler was traded from the Broncos to the Bears for two first-round draft picks.
Yeah.
What you think?
I'm going to say, it's like a push. Right?
Ricky Williams was traded from the Saints to the Dolphins for two first-round picks.
I don't know if I'd have did that one.
Yeah,
I like Ricky, but I don't know if I'd have.
But that was the age of the running back.
True. So. And then the Wayback Machine, Keyshawn Johnson from the Jets to the Buccaneers for two first-round draft picks.
I don't think I would have did that one, but
they
that's
got
just
a Super
me.
Bowl, but I don't know if he really made a difference.
Jalen Ramsey to the Rams for two first-round picks. Stay tuned to NFL Network on that one.
Hey, we got to play with that swag. It's on us. It's on us. You're not strong enough.
Did you guys see? Ramsey hardly moved on that push-off.
We're going to lock him down. Y'all get after him.
It is knocked and picked.
That is one of the most incredible interceptions I have ever seen.
Hey, you can't win me, Gronk.
Fires downfield. A diving interception by Jalen Ramsey.
Duval!
The one where Ramsey gets traded to the Rams. This is Good Morning Football. Come on in. We're live in New York, breaking it all down here on a Wednesday, October 16th. My name is Kay Adams. We've got Peter Schrager and Kyle Brandt, of course, and Sean O'Hara joining us.
Hey, what's up, O'Hero? How are we doing?
To you guys.
Good to have him.
We got a great show.
We'll get to the Ramsey stuff very shortly.
The one where Ramsey gets traded. I know that one. But also, guys, officiating. A lot of officiating talk. State of the league. Future of the league. We are live at the Fall League meeting. The powers that be. There's Mr. Jones. They're all there. We have reporters. Mr. Lurie. We will talk about it. Mr. Goodell. Everyone together at that Fall League meeting talking about the things that matter. Plus, do you like the long plays? Do you like the long runs, the long bombs?
I do!
Yeah. We have them in the hottest new game show this side of the Masked Singer. It's called The Long Show. Robbie's still running. We love this segment. A lot of fun today. And guys, after the Patriots, who's the best team in the AFC? I happen to think they play in Buffalo. I think it's the Bills. And we have the head coach, Sean McDermott, coming on this morning.
Whoa.
Talking about them coming off the bye week. Are they gonna, is this a 12-win team, guys? Look at the schedule. It's really friendly. McDermott coming on this morning.
We had the bologna sandwich eating coach Doug Marrone on the show about a week ago, talking all things Jags, State of the Union, his relationship with Jalen Ramsey. And then last night, huge news out of L.A. The Rams traded for Jaguars cornerback Jalen Ramsey after trading away Marcus Peters to the Baltimore Ravens. The Rams posted this on IG. You can't spell Ramsey without Rams.
Gotcha. How
are they sitting on that one, I wonder?
Yeah.
Ian Rapoport is in Fort Lauderdale live at the Fall League meeting. Here to break down some huge stories yesterday. Give us everything you know.
Yeah, no doubt. It was a huge day for the Los Angeles Rams yesterday, completely remaking their defense. Let's start with the biggest move that the Rams have done really in several years, trading for Jaguars Pro Bowl cornerback Jalen Ramsey, who, of course, has been the target of media speculation, trade talks, and everything over the course of the last month. We know that Ramsey demanded a trade from the Jaguars. Owner Shad Khan specifically wanted to make sure that they, one, either did not trade him, or two, if they were going to trade and they needed two first-round picks, they actually got more than that. One first-round pick this year, one first-round pick next year, and a late rounder in 2021 as well. And now Jalen Ramsey goes from the Jaguars to the Los Angeles Rams. Expect them to play a lot more man-to-man defense, really lock down some receivers and get after people like they have not done for most of this year. But obviously, that was not all the Rams did yesterday. They also did a little subtraction in their secondary. Marcus Peters, their Pro Bowl corner, they traded for such fanfare from the Kansas City Chiefs a couple years ago. He goes from Los Angeles to the Baltimore Ravens, who, by the way, were also one of the teams involved in the Jalen Ramsey mix. Kenny Young, a linebacker formerly of UCLA, he goes over along with another draft pick. So the LA Rams remake their secondary. The Baltimore Ravens have a huge addition, and the Jacksonville Jaguars clear the decks, add a ton of picks, including two first-rounders, and all of this happened on a random Tuesday in the NFL season.
Mm-hmm. And the Ravens, of course, inherit a nice little tandem now with Marcus Peters and Marlon Humphrey, who's been playing lights out this season. And then A.J. Boye is alone down there in Jacksonville. We'll get to all of it. Thank you so much, Ian Rapoport, for the breakdown here. Ramsey, by the way, yeah, I think he likes his new uniform. From Jacksonville to L.A., he goes posting this photo on Twitter shortly after Ian Rapoport broke the news of the trade to L.A. Peter, how did this go down?
Yeah, look, the Rams might be 3-3. They view themselves as the aggressors in the NFL. That's how they view themselves on the field, and they view themselves off the field. They look at themselves that way when they traded for Talib, Cooks, and Peters last year, when they traded for Dante Fowler midseason, and when they went out and signed Clay Matthews and Eric Weddle this offseason. They saw Jalen Ramsey as the best cornerback in the market, and they said, if we could add the best cornerback in the market, maybe the best cornerback in all of football, to the best defensive tackle in all of football, with who we believe is one of the best quarterbacks and offenses in all of football, we're going to always compete. This trade would have been made, and I'm told this from Rams people, if they were 3-3 as they are, 0-6, or 6-0. It's just one of those deals where they saw Ramsey available, they made the calls, he was available, for two first-round picks, which is a bounty. I don't think, besides Khalil Mack, I've ever seen a defensive player traded for that much. But here's the connection. Les Snead and Dave Caldwell work together. They're the two GMs of these teams. They worked together in Atlanta through the mid-2000s. Two guys who have known each other forever. They always have an open line of communication. Once the two first-round picks were brought up, then the Jaguars said, okay, we'll loosen up on the we're not going to trade Jalen Ramsey side of it. One key note, the Rams believe that Jalen Ramsey will be healthy, will not miss any more time with that back injury.
Oh, the back might feel okay?
Might feel okay.
Oh, that's awesome.
And they also view Jalen Ramsey as someone who's on a contract right now that they will honor, that is not necessarily going to do the Khalil Mack or Aaron, I need a new contract once I'm traded, or Antonio Brown. Jalen Ramsey, they believe, will play, or at least they're under the belief, will play under this current contract and is not going to ask to have it teared up and written a new one immediately.
Oh.
So you get Ramsey on his rookie deal still. You get rid of Peters. You move Ramsey in there. And guess who's up this weekend? Julio Jones.
Hey.
Let's go. They're 3-3. They view themselves ready. And by the way, they've got a stadium to open. It doesn't hurt to have one of the biggest personalities added to that mix in Jalen Ramsey.
Great call.
What do you think, Sean? Get after it.
Well, I mean, that's the quickest backiotomy I think I've ever seen.
That's fast.
Go back on the field. But you mentioned he's going to have to fly to L.A., all right, join his new team. They come back to the Atlanta Falcons and play Julio Jones. That's a tough task. I love the move for the Rams because they just put Talib on IR, obviously. They moved Marcus Peters. But not just the physical play. This Rams defense has lacked an identity. And now you get a guy in Jalen Ramsey into this locker room that has, obviously, you know, look, he's got the fortitude, he's got the track record of what he has done on the
outside.
Isn't
that Marcus Peters, though?
He's bringing a little bit of attitude, but Marcus Peters was not the same Marcus Peters this year. All right, I watched him too many times chasing after receivers on deep plays. This secondary has been a liability for the Rams. So this was needed. This was needed even before Aqib Talib went on IR. They needed some life at the corner position. Wade Phillips likes to play a lot more man, not zone. All right, they played a lot more cover three, a lot more zone down in Jacksonville. So this will be interesting to see how Jalen fits into that scheme. But I like the personality that it brings. I don't want happy Ramsey, by the way.
Sure.
I don't want happy. I want angry Jalen Ramsey. I know he's happy. He's got his new team. And
LA's
he's
a hard place to be angry.
Out in California. Yeah. But I want him fired up. I want him. The guy that we all loved is the guy that was trash talking and backing it all up. That's what they need.
No, it's a, I think that's the one they're going to get, too. I think this is the first Rams win in a month. I think this is huge. You look at the price tag. It's so expensive, and it blows your hair back. All those picks. I don't care about picks. I like players. I like a bird in the hand. If I was to say to you guys, I'll give you three New York scratchers, or I'll give you $50. Take the $50. Do you think that the Bears are happy with the picks they spent for Khalil Mack, or the Cowboys for Amari Cooper, or the Texans for Laremy Tunsil?
Yeah.
They got one of the most top five coveted players in football at the right position. Is it expensive? Hell yes. It's L.A. It's $100 for valet. But when you pull up in an Aston Martin, who gives a damn? They just got one.
But bankruptcy is really hot in L.A. too. If you look at what they're where they're putting their money, they're paying some great players at the top of their position. Jared Goff is top of his position pretty much. Aaron Donald is. Todd Gurley is. Brandon Cooks. Robert Woods doesn't nothing to sneeze at. He's making above $7 million a year. So how small is this window? I like that they're aggressors. I like that their mindset isn't 3-3. It's better. But were they the difference between Marcus Peters and Jalen Ramsey away from going back to the Super Bowl, from being what they were last year? I'm not sure that that's true. They've got the offensive line issues, the backfield issues. So from the Jags side, and we'll discuss all of that, what that means and what the Super Bowl window is screaming at these Rams and their fan base. From the Jags side, they now have 4 first-round picks over the next 2 years. They have 18 picks. That's a lot of scratchers. Odds are you might be building for your future. And I'd like to just pose the question, what more could the front office have done other than back up a Brinks truck to a player who didn't want to be there?
Yeah.
What? Like, how could they have handled this differently? Didn't the Jags sort of win here pulling in that haul?
It's tough because the front office is complicated. I feel like they had a window to sign him to that deal and maybe they blew it. However, if I'm a Jags fan this morning, we know a lot of them watch the show. I'm pissed off. I'm furious. We just lost our best player. We lost one of the best players the franchise has ever had. I would have lied down behind his car in the parking lots and let him leave. I think it's a loss.
But I like that the second thing's with bad trades. They didn't say, okay, let's take the first offer and trade him. They waited. I like even just that. The fact that they waited a month, the back injuries, that I'm not playing, that I don't feel good. And they waited until it was just right and got a lot back for him. They got 3 picks, 2 in the first round.
Thing I think when I was doing work on calling around the league, everyone's like, yeah, Jaguars want 2 first round picks for Jalen Ramsey, and a lot of other teams are like, you don't give up 2 first round picks for a guy who's going to be in a free agent next year. They got 2 first round picks and then some. So from the Jaguar side of it, he wasn't on the field, and I'll tell you, there's a lot of expectation that he was going to be able to go last weekend. And when he didn't go last weekend and didn't play Sunday, I think that kind of felt like, all right, maybe he's never going to play for us again. Both sides, to me, both sides are winners this week.
Yeah.
I know that's easy to say, and we want to do an immediate hot take. Rams got a guy that's going to be a difference maker, and the Jaguars are set up for the future with 2 first-round picks. I like that, too.
It's
amazing
the
turnaround,
well,
because it was trending in the opposite direction.
Yes.
It was trending bad. So to your point, the fact that they got that run, I don't think they were actively trying to trade him.
I don't either.
But when you get that call, you can't turn that down. I mean, it's like what the Giants got for Odell Beckham.
Mm.
You get that call, that 2 first-round picks, Mr. Khan, yes, we're going to what?
Sure.
Sell.
Like, the trade deadline
right
is the 29th. We've got a ways to go. So maybe the Rams make some more moves. Maybe the Eagles make a move. We'll talk about other teams that we think should be aggressive as we look ahead to Week 7, which is, by the way, a night away.
Here we go.
Chiefs, Broncos, let's go. But let's talk about the AFC East. Are we overlooking the Bills as serious contenders this season?
Yes.
Frigs, they weren't in your top 5, were they?
They were not in my top 5.
NFC
4-1 and no Bills.
Well, Sean McDermott's on the show.
I want to hear what
he thinks.
We've
got some splaining to do, and there's plenty to talk about at the league meetings down in Fort Lauderdale. The Fall League meeting. We will go there live to Judy Batista next.